sleeping in there, and it's really funny. So that's what I was laughing at. And who's eating potato chips?
Potato chips? No, how dare you. In other news, wait, stop press. TS Train Simulator has finally converted to 64-bit. Let's see how bad we can break it. Hello, Yugles. I am Steven, and welcome to a TS 2019 testing stream. Let's see, as I said, let's see how just how badly we can break the game and see just how long it will take before we then get a dump file. But before that, before we do all of that, I want my Jacob's crackers.
It's HD.
What?
If it doesn't dump file, we need to change that dump file imminent screen.
If it does give me a dump file, I'm still keeping a dump screen as it is.
Okay.
Considering the game has yet to take the shit for me.
Taking the shit for everyone else.
That is the key word though. Yet.
Yes. It is very. It is in the dictionary, right between the words "gullible" and "American."
And what better way, as some people may have guessed from the thumbnail, what better way of testing the TS2019 to see just how badly it can break than taking Ella Barkley, the Great Western Railway Duke Dog, with, oh, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 coaches on the yet to be updated Seven Valley Railway route, because the last time I was on the Seven Valley, it was laggy as all arse, especially in a couple of areas. So, let's unbreak pause, and let's see how bad it is. Camera jump there, if they all notice. Blah, 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 blah. Just like that. And don't worry, I will be covering a Duke Dog review of this soon, because there are, that's going to make me sick. Because there are a couple of things I've noticed on this that I am going to pick up on, and possibly even rant about as well. Right, stop shoveling. So, 3, 2, 1. Away we go.
This is GWR, not Caledonian or LMS.
No. We're going after either of this or that, but if you don't answer what you ask them, you won't get an answer.
Road vehicle beeping in the background, so I'm pushing back.
No, someone thought that the engine he was driving was LMS, and I'm like, no, it's GWR.
Really? Really? Someone thought this engine was LMS, considering the fact it has GWR on the tender!
Idiot.
Asking
for is
how much
a
prepare quickly you prepare, so
I question. I just took it as he thought it was either one of those companies.
We've had this question before, John, just
to answer. And that's lovely. Why the hell would you put cattle trucks in a Toyota brand?
Cracker, I think. I'll.
And it is time for me to do 50 through Bishop Hawthorne. I do not care. I am nuts.
I don't really go too fast because old Brie Viaduct's coming up and that's got a 15 limit.
Oh.
Well, the Duke Dog class was built in 1938. When the class originally had names, but the people that they were named after took an instant dislike to the locomotives and ordered their names to be taken off the engines, and they were then put onto castles, which is why, if you read through the history of the castles, you notice that some of them had actually been renamed from, like, whatever castle to like Earl of something. car now.
Sounded very happy when you got the little multiple toots in a row for the first time when you're trying to do the outro.
Yeah, I was so happy when I did that. Meanwhile, Stuart, I'm taking it out of the bar because I almost have the valley.
Why not?
I wish it was in 2009.
Double heading with City of Chiro, nonetheless.
Yes.
Oh, got a bit of lag.
Aye.
Correction, I'm getting a fair bit of lag.
It's a Range Rover.
The fact it doesn't rock. That's no problem with the early Range Rovers.
I'm going to go to Quick Drive. I'm trying to think, is the Bluebell Railway
no
Quick
ABS,
Drive?
No ABS, no sunroof, no air suspension, no memory seats. But he only wants $2,500 for it, and has no rust on it.
Somebody's asking, what do you think of the Simply Little Sport?
Aye?
Somebody's asking, what do you think of the Simply Little Sport?
No idea.
I haven't got an opinion on that one way or the other. Let me see it. Let me have a play on it, and then I'll give you my opinion.
Ow.
Hence why I said.
That's enough. Network Rail is urging drivers in Cambridgeshire to wise up and size up their vehicle and plan their route ahead. Plan their route before setting out, after a transit van was the 15th vehicle to hit a railway bridge in Estonia near March this year. I'm going to put this in real train picks. because this is technically a train pick, but because it's a railway bridge.
I need a map. What?
There's a map that somebody's made, and they've put it as the United Kingdom of England, Wales and Northern Ireland, and they've had Scotland as separate.
Guys, please. We've had enough of these questions. We've already had enough of those questions. We don't need any more, thank you very much. Besides, what's the point in versus when we're all gonna say the same damn thing, which is we like them no matter what they are.
Don't care.
About you guys, but so far driving the Duke Dog, has anyone noticed with their like when they're driving the steam engines now that it's gone to 64-bit that you don't get as much the big mushroom cloud of smoke coming out the chimney each time you open the reg?
I noticed that.
I noticed that as well.
Right. Back of the 25 limit, let's open a wide up. Come on, Bartley.
Oh, Lord. They got John Terry on Sky One. I'm guessing, Stephen, you don't know who John Terry is.
Not really.
He's a footballer who is known for, sleeping with his teammates' wives. I was tempted to do one of those scenarios, but I didn't have enough time.
I'm actually tempted to make, if you want me to, I can write a scenario for you.
No, it's fine.
But I am going to get a pick and do something with it.
Is there a North Metro still up in the Stanya port? No idea.
Of course they are, they're just keeping quiet about it.
They want to keep hush-hush about it.
And not the Gresby interpretation of it either.
Yeah. So how is TS-2019 so far? Apart from the fact that it's going to be from the tail,
I'm actually finding it a lot of fun.
I actually find the points a lot better too as well.
In fact, I've had a hell of a time trying to load the Bluebell back before the update, and now the bell runs nicely. And I think it's a, and I will say this, it's nice to actually have stuff that doesn't fucking crash. Or, you know, its crashes are less frequent.
Unless you're people in RSUG. Because everyone on there seems to be getting it.
We know this morning,
coming out soon.
Oh, this isn't taking a drill, this is a bad one. Quiet, hang on.
There's a little miniature railway. It's got something going on it.
Probably a pannier.
Yeah, pannier's going at some speed though.
And think Stephen. Next week you'll be seeing a little model railway. In the Norwegian carriages.
And probably meet up with the
Actually, no. I'm not entirely sure if we will see Kedzen or not.
No, not Kedzen. No, just true.
We might see him. We don't know.
Yes, we saw the
4517.
We did see the Bone SCTF is going to be named Civilian McElfine.
I was the one that spotted it. And put it in the Discord server.
Mate, it feels good. No, he didn't overshoot the platform. Well.
No, I didn't overshoot the platform, considering the fact how small the platform...
That's how 7 Valley do it.
Yeah, that's how 7 Valley do it, and that's how small it is.
Yeah.
Besides, the only the other platform is only used when another train's coming down.
Ah, which makes sense.
Otherwise, it's always this side.
Next.
Nah, check it back.
Right, we don't ask those. We don't answer those questions.
What?
Either more.
Because we already know what engine's better anyway.
Besides, I'm gonna be kind of honest. Those are questions that are bound to start a fight.
Look, as I can tell you right now, the E2 is shit.
So could I.
Because the Pannier is more realistic.
The problem I have with the E2 is it seems like a bucket. Last time I checked, it's not a bucket.
It's meant to steam like a fucking... Well, I don't know. It's meant to steam like a Y-14 in game! And the Y-14 should steam like the E-2.
And then the Hunter Fitzwilliams are just checking.
And for some reason, the E-2 has got the correct rolling friction, and the Y-14 does not.
Yes,
you even tried seeing what the problem was, Steve. You still couldn't fix it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, northeast
morning. Unless I've got one idea.
What?
Unless it's too fat, it's too heavy.
I think he made it too heavy.
That's true, because I modified the rolling friction so they're barely, so it was almost as if it had tink and roller bearings on it, and yet it was still dragging. So I'll have a look at that and see whether it is too heavy.
Because if you do, when you do have a look, give me a shout, because I can easily tell you what weight it is. Empty.
Yeah, you just need to set over
Right, because it's under J15, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's in here. J20, not too far.
I have arrived at King's Cove.
No, it's still too far.
Come on, coaches. In the platform.
That's Skyfox. This is the 7th Valley. This is the 7th Valley. It used to be on Steam Sound Supreme, but they took it off.
Weren't they like waiting to re-release it?
It's waiting to be re-released because it's 64-bit. Now that that's out, it might be out, I don't know, probably a couple of weeks or so.
Of looking at the weight when it's full, it's 37 tons, 200 weight.
That's when it's full?
Yeah, 37. So that's 37.1 tons.
Oh, I just 200 weight, okay.
0.1 of a ton.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right, so where would I find the weight of the thing, Steve?
The weight of the engine, I think it's in the top bin. If it's not in there, it'll be in simulation.
That's the fuel mass.
No, it's right above. Is it drip though?
That's bottom mass.
No, it will go.
He was close though.
He was half right.
The Bulldogs are a different class entirely. In fact,
the Duke Dogs is a mixture between the Dukes and the Bulldog class. So he was half right.
Yeah, isn't it a boiler from a Duke from a Bulldog? Or is it the other way around?
It's a Duke boiler and a Bulldog chassis.
Okay, I was right the first time.
Yep, stay.
Is it too heavy?
It's too heavy.
Well, what's he set it at?
Let me compare it to the actual mass it should be. Horrex, if you're listening, update it now, please.
And also, fix your tender fucking coupling. And tender is not a wagon.
Chris got that right first time.
Give him shit.
Yeah, for some reason.
Yes. Get faster, just tell me so much to run faster.
Ooh, you okay, Cam?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Ooh, I see sharp thorn tongues.
Steven, do you want to know how many tons it's overweight?
15.
Exactly. It's 15 tons overweight. It should be 37, not 52.
Jesus Christ. Is that just the locomotive itself? What about the tender?
That's the engine itself.
What about the tender?
I'm about to check the tender.
I'm about to guess the tender.
Because I'm wondering if he's fucked up and put the locomotive locomotive weight as both the locomotive and the tender weight.
That's what I'm thinking.
Wait, so 52.
Yes, go for
it. It would still be underweight because 67 tons. With the tender.
Yes,
go for it.
Yes,
going to Kino. Which is actually a decent clock. Mass.
Do you know, for about, what, 3.5 hours?
Yeah.
Okay, tender might be a bit underweight, I think. Put it at 15 tons.
And it should be,
when full, 30.
So it's underweight.
But then again, I'm guessing he's adding on for the weight of the coal and water, which I guess is fair enough.
That's fine. Why am I not getting water in the boiler?
Seriously, water in that boiler does not weigh 15 fucking tons.
Not really. And I don't know why, but I think people, would you agree with me, guys, that the tender should not be acting like a freaking wagon? It should be a proper tender. I don't know about you, but I feel like that affects the way you fire the engine.
Halt.
minute back.
And it is an Alex.
What's up, Chuckle Nuts?
Driving train.
We found out why the Y14 has such high rolling friction.
Oh, we finally figured out that Easter egg, didn't we?
It's too fat.
It's too fat. It needs exercise.
It's too heavy.
That would be what. So, let's see. How would one go about trimming some weight off of it, aside from tossing it at the nearest scrap merchant?
Going into the bin file. Nintendo's fine. I checked it and pretty much compared it to what, because how much coal and water it's got. I'm guessing it pretty much had it as empty. But even when the boiler's full with water, it does not weigh 52 tons.
Oh, absolutely. What the fuck? 52 tons?
When it should be weighing about 37.
What the hell?
And that's when it's full, Alex.
That's the thing, figure out how much it weighs when it loses about 50.
Well, I don't know how much the boiler can hold, that's the only problem.
You're back.
Really? Oh.
That's nice.
But also,
another thing they added to the quick drives that I noticed is you can sort your engine by country and steam and whether they're mainline, historical, or whatever.
And I'm back.
And I'm pulling in.
I'm passing over. Get it? Neither do I.
Well, considering I'm driving on the bell.
So, what is on the docket for this evening?
I'm driving on the Seven Valley with Duke Dog.
Did that finally drop?
No. Still the beta version.
Still beta version. But he has
I'm probably gonna
buy
a double scale
back. Are you live?
Yeah. Breathington Smythe.
We've been live for the past 30 minutes.
Breathington Smythe!
What do you want, you capitalist?
Hey, hello! Fuck this.
Capitalist.
Oh, hey, Stuart.
What?
Here maybe in about 20 minutes or so. I wonder if I can get some more Tane help from you.
I'll go on.
I'm missing a lot. There are two parts I'm missing for a three-part listen to, basically.
Let me get you back home.
Yes, I am. I'm booting up right now.
Alright. So. When you're ready, just send me the coords over and I'll go look for them.
Alrighty. Well, the thing is, they're not missing.
What do you mean they're not missing?
They're faulty.
Does it say why?
I need 30 seconds to make the spot by the fucking clothes and I'll tell you. Come on.
I forgot you so big, yeah, so big serious fat that you quite heavy.
Yeah, I might as well just.
Why would you want to
sit in your way from yourself? Don't toy with me, you
sassy minx! I'm really short for the comment.
Well, okay. Salt Lake City was one of the major towns that was considered.
Salt Lake City, you call.
was considered part of the Plate Department. And he was also considered one of the first towns to be fully communitized, if you will.
Communized.
Well, no, like it's a full community.
I'm sorry.
It was also the first town to experiment with different, with extract. I think it was the first town. Now, I could be 100% wrong. I don't care. It was the first town to experiment with the idea of extracting salt from the water there. And ever since then, it has become a popular, it was a popular place. Like I said, I could be wrong, but I don't know.
Sing, Jukebox, sing!
I'm gonna get shot for that. Steven?
Yeah?
The review video was fucking great, mate.
Oh yeah.
You're going to get shot and beaten for that, Cameron.
Your review video was shit.
Go fuck yourself.
Later.
Nope, Steven, that's what he has his girl for.
Yes, exactly. Yes, yes. I forgot I could play that card.
No, no, keep forgetting.
Hang on. Straight for goal?
No, I don't have a girlfriend, I just forgot I could play that card.
Rhett forgot that he has someone to play Big Tatas with.
To be honest, I've been too busy with work.
Hold on, I am going to share a...
Who the fuck's touching? Who the fuck is touching?
Look at Cameron, not me, I'm innocent here.
I'm looking at Alex for that.
Okay,
who moved me?
There is the Stuart. When you ask that question, there is one of two people who has the ability to move people. Well,
Ranty just mine. What? Dickhead.
By the way,
I've been called one!
By the way, when people are done.
Wait, I could call your voice, but I'm stream.
To be honest, you can call me disabled, that's probably the worst thing to call.
Well, you said that I get.
That would be smart.
Yes, I have a heart, and I have a heart.
Really? You? More people?
No. Stop the press, Cam has a heart.
Yeah, I think we're gonna get one.
Quick, stab
him! Okay, Stuart.
What?
For this, errors of warning. The failed to open. No, what? I'm just gonna...
Wow, there's a lot of lag at Arley.
Yeah, Stuart, I'll send you a screen cap of what I'm seeing right now for these.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna get one of these British Rail Land Rovers.
And yeah, if I do this, not a problem.
Print screen. Like, turn performance mode on or off?
No, I'm looking at the buffers, and it's like, yeah, not a problem. But as soon as I go to view, it's like, yeah.
That?
No.
All of the lamps on the platform, I think, are causing this.
Yeah.
That's interesting. We're not getting temp dumps. People are getting access violations. That's interesting.
It's part of the temp dump system.
Also, that and also, they haven't fully worked out programming.
There you go, Stuart. I have sent the issues to you. Also, who's joined us? It's a Nathan! Hello, Nathan.
Everyone's here.
Yeah.
Well, not everyone. We're missing Ben, we're missing Shy, we're missing Also, are we still live?
Tribal band.
Yeah, we are live. We're live.
I know, I saw that.
We're like Davina. We're live in the house.
Okay.
Please don't swear.
Oh, fuck off, you tosser.
Right. Okay. Alex, I have encountered this one before.
You have?
Mm-hmm.
What is the issue?
All you'll need to do is pretty much change a couple of letters in the config file.
Okay. Let's see if I can actually access the config
file. Yes, change a couple of letters in the config file and change a couple of letters. If I actually check if the files are there first. Open it for editing, then go into the file that it's in.
Open for editing.
Show an explorer.
Let me do that for both the engine.
Answer
the
me this. Why does that station look so familiar?
What station are you talking about?
I want to say Arley, but I'm probably wrong.
Okay.
So we'll start.
Alright, open for edit, and then show an explorer, right?
I don't know why the station looks familiar.
It worked.
What?
It's not doing the thing.
Ugh. I don't know why it does it, why it's not doing it for you.
Nope. There's something I really want to try right now.
What's that?
I've got, if I'm correct, a 64-bit...
3 grams of coke in your pocket.
No. But, Trinson just updated to 64-bit, right?
Yeah.
My question is, I wonder if my other version updated.
That's what we were wondering earlier.
Yeah.
You have to go.
I love the wheels on this little Healy.
Okay.
Steven, did you actually look up what the consist rate was for the Severn Valley?
This, behind Barclay, this was the actual rake, or as close as I can get it, to what 4566 the Small Prairie was running before she went out of ticket. This was her last train.
Funny, because I think I've actually got a spreadsheet with the rolling stock on the SVR with the sets.
Gave me the option to pick between 64-bit and regular. Anyway.
Nathan.
Yeah.
If you. If you go into your Steam and right click on Train Simulator and your games library, you should be on the floor.
Yeah.
Make sure you pan it.
Yeah, I did. Let's see. Somebody, what's a route that would be great to look at the difference on?
A very waggy one that you usually get.
I'm going to go to. Go, John.
Two routes I've had trouble with. Bluebell, Weirdale, Teasdale. Giving me no trouble now.
Oh, guys, how about this for a shot? Look. Barclay going over Victoria Bridge.
I need to wait. Dream.
Stuart.
What?
Thank you for teaching me how to drive the JT Quan on this route.
Well, failed. All because of me. Yeah. Attempted but failed due to, me forgetting about the fire.
Yeah, Stuart overcome the firebox.
I kept the firebox door open.
Dang it, I can't open them both at the same time.
No. But I am. Ooh. Yes,
it opened!
I'm halfway to my favorite place on the Bluebell.
What's the Keynes?
I've already passed for the Keynes. I've got a picture of my newest toy at Horston.
I'm not dying to jump over them.
Look in the SK.
Wait a minute. Top Hat fellow is saying that apparently Steam Sound Supreme assets. Steam Sound Supreme stuff doesn't work.
Odd, because I've got Steam Sound Supreme stuff working.
Huh. Must be case-by-case basis, huh?
It is. Plus, like I said, the game... Because the 64-bit just rolled out, not all the bugs are ironed out. So, it's going to take them a little bit of time, but as the bugs get ironed out, things will start to work.
Hey guys, should I make this school here deaf as I go by with a juke dog?
Yes! Yes. Roof it! Roof it!
Rick, oh joy!
Hold on. Let me do this.
Break
what's
in 6 about
now!
In football news, Scotland lost.
Aww.
Israel.
Somebody give me a locomotive. Or a couple locomotives.
After a dog fight.
Do you have the JT,
No, like,
do
stuff
you have
that...
any JT steam locomotive?
Okay, here's the thing. It's gotta be stuff from various, like, companies. Like, Mesh Tools, RC...
BMG Block 5.
No.
It has to be available to the store.
Mesh Tools Super D.
Yeah,
oh,
Super
yeah.
D.
Super D.
Alright. So let's see what happens here. I'll double click my TS icon.
And I'm gonna be passing over the incorrect bridge.
I'm passing over. Get it? Who do you want?
You wanna use that one?
I know.
But anyway,
judging. Even you may have set the roof of that school on fire.
You what, sorry?
Oh, I was good.
You may have just set the roof of that school on fire.
Man, the kids will appreciate it.
Yeah.
It's not like they were learning anything anyway.
Yeah, really.
No school! Hold on. I gotta do this. Today, class, I will be teaching you how to pick your nose. But we already know how to do that, Mr. Berkeley.
And how to scratch your butt.
I am going to be teaching that. That is on the curriculum, and then we will give you a standardized test.
Anyway, what's up, Joe?
Yeah, Alex, it won't let me download it for some reason.
Why not?
I have no idea.
Whoa. Yep. Whoa! Okay.
What?
Launch screen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fucking cool.
It is.
Fuck. Perfect.
Yeah.
Oh, that splash screen. Fucking Rio Grande SD40 right in the middle. Oh, that's perfect.
Yep.
Oh, beautiful.
Time.
Okay, so, Stuart, I think I'll just send you, the one I have, but... Okay, so... But before I do that, where do I go... Set this thing up for 64 bits. Do I have to do
this? Right, Alex, what you need to do is you've opened the ES, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Did it come up with the train simulator 64 bit edition?
Came up with a 32 bit.
Right, see if you close the ES.
Okay.
Open your Steam.
Steam.
Yes.
At the website. Hang on.
Okay.
Steam's coming up still, hang on.
These crackers are really good with some butter.
I got your butter right here.
Wait, Alex, you got Steam up.
Alright, library installed, okay.
Right, at the west side in the games library, right click on Train Simulator.
Mm-hmm. Ah! Place.
There you go. And make sure you pin that one. Otherwise,
okay.
every time you go to your taskbar and click the icon, it'll keep opening the 32 bit.
Yeah.
How do I pin that though? Oh, hang on. Steam is having a bit of a derp. Wait a minute!
That was something for everyone else to chat with.
I'll wake up.
64 bit if you're if your PC has what is it, 64 bit operating system?
Which is pretty much everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, 64 bit. Awesome. So how do I pin it then?
Okay, I'll walk you through this one. So right, go down to the taskbar, right click on it.
Is this still in Steam or no?
No, it's on
Wait,
the taskbar at the bottom of your screen.
Alex,
can you
point
to the
full screen?
Wait. Thank you. So here, next one. Beautiful.
I'm
very interested to see how many frames per second I get now. Because normally I've been hovering right around 45, 50.
Well, mine's double. Oh,
yo, this is so much fucking faster now. Holy shit.
Yeah.
Holy shit. Alright.
And
I'm gonna get my stopwatch out here. Let me see how long it takes.
Oh, Alex,
you're now. Yes. Alright, so. Let's see how long it takes to load up a route. I'm gonna do Adriana County.
I timed it to 15 seconds.
Alright, here we go.
Also, I have arrived at my end station.
Yeah. I'm posting something in Train Sim Pics. It's a screenshot, but it is Train Sim.
Okay.
See it. What? What is? I don't know why I'm laughing.
Nathan, what did you do?
That is cool.
I put four
He's got the 32
down.
And the 64 bit open.
Alex?
Yeah. Huh?
Apparently, you're laughing so well.
Sorry! Maybe Eddie, this is why you should have headphones.
And then I'm gonna put one more thing in the TSFX.
Somebody asked me something, I'm not sure what to do about that.
Michael B. asked if he can join us. I'm just gonna say.
So far, 1 minute 45 seconds.
What, that already
done? Yep. They're working on it.
I was going to ask, guys, with the 64 bit, what do you guys think? Think it would be quick enough to make custom consists now?
2 minutes, 10 seconds to load up.
Quicker.
Yeah, it's a lot quicker. I used to sit here for 5 minutes waiting for this to load up. Alright, so now we're gonna go to the heaviest, dense one I have. What? Graphics.
Maybe that would be the one more interesting.
Yeah,
full screen,
put
a lift in the
cloud.
Safe.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay, so, saved it. I need to send this file. Let's see. Stuart, I'm going to try and send you this through Discord here, see if this works.
I'll be right back.
Stuart's still there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Okay. Try to send it to you through Discord. Nope, too powerful. God damn it. Alright. How do I...
It's a fucking... I'm just calling it the musical note lesson now.
Hey guys.
Yeah?
Hmm. What other funny things should I do now that I have two versions of the same game? What should I drive and put them next to each other?
No, what you could do, you get... Do you have the 119 in Jupiter?
I don't.
Ah!
Oh, I know what you're going
Damn,
for, though.
That would've been a cool picture. Yeah, you would... Yeah.
Just put them on the same track, pointing towards each other. Going...
Train Fan 4014, it dropped today, dude.
See, we're at Bewdley, so make sure that my road's set all the way to Kidderminster. Once we get to Kidderminster, we'll just
Kidderminster, okay,
hop on over to another route and see what's what.
Just to know what I'd be interested to see.
What?
Hmm.
A race between a 32-bit and a 64-bit.
32-bit? Dump dump.
64-bit
Okay.
Access
violation. Hey, Stuart.
What?
What? You use send anywhere, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let me see if I can do this here. There it is.
Come on, dude. Dog.
Four.
Oh, go on, girl.
What do you mean, how? For, yeah, 2019, dude, 64-bit, now.
God, if you can hear the stream, just listen to her.
Well, I've got a minute, so. Fork.
I have the stream muted so it doesn't pick up.
Maybe I had
the noise.
What do you think I've got? The main problem is, when I use headphones and talk to you, every time you ask a question, like, every time a question was on the stream.
If only I could somehow, like, have the two trains running at the same time.
What? Stuart.
Huh?
That's what's telling me to send you for you on send anywhere.
Out in the menu, I am pulling 120 degrees.
Stretching legs.
Well, with this... Well, a Train Fan 4014, I don't understand what do you mean how? Like, are you trying to actually access 2019? Because we actually did cover it earlier on the stream, so... Mm-hmm. Say about maybe 5-10 minutes ago.
Oh god, bark baby, bark!
Help!
Not yo, yo,
that is... I still find the Duke Bombs to be very cute.
They work though.
Yeah.
Kid Bash 2 engines,
they
bloody work.
I'm not gonna deny it. Yeah.
True.
I'm not gonna deny the fact that they work.
Give me. I want popcorn.
Sure, give me popcorn.
My 32-bit loaded up before my 64-bit.
Wow.
32 has got less it's got to work with.
Oh, why are you here? That's why you loaded up so much slower. You're on the wrong route.
What's wrong?
Oh, Nathan. Don't ever change.
Okay. Okay, why don't we exit out and try this again?
One of 100.
You're a dick.
Wander up.
You're a dick, Harry.
Wow, they won't have to be
sad.
Okay. Do I even try and avoid this?
Oh yeah, listen to her now.
Oh my god.
Do what?
Victorian lads watching our stream.
Oh, hey Chris.
Hey, there he is. Hey Chris.
I don't know what's happening in my mind.
Neither do I, so don't tell us.
Much. We're just kind of gushing over the smallest of things in the 64-bit TS.
Not only that, but here's the thing. I could put down a lot. I could put down like 12 or 15 back before the update. And after I got my gaming rig, I could put down about 9 engines max before it would have crashed. Now I could put out about 15, 20.
Hey Nathan, on your sort of side comparison, which one's 64-bit on your system?
Say again?
The
64-bit one is on the right for his.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can tell the lighting's different on it.
Yeah.
Might be Eddie or someone. Or no, actually, yeah. No, it might be. Might also be Mrs. because she's got the. Oh, it was Eddie.
It was Eddie.
Yeah.
Because your Mrs. and Brett are both. Come here, Western Minds of Scotland.
Okay, this is really messing with my computer.
having two of the same game up at the same time, I'm not surprised.
Yeah. Hey, what? Hey, what? Up, love. Just noticed in one of the gardens there was a woman in a bathing suit. I'm like, hey, up.
I was like, oh, hello. Quick, whistle, Rupertrania.
No, never mind.
That's my friend. Okay. So, one of my friends is Steve Davies, and he works up at the Langofflin. He was up, he was on, I can't remember what these he was on. I think he was on the 31. I don't know what he was playing up there.
Let me guess, he went, beep, 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 beep.
And a pair of skinny dippers in the creek.
I heard this one.
Along the line. Great.
Yeah, I know Steve Davies. He's in Glen Server.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
I see Brittany came back and then muted himself.
Nice guy.
Just the old crap out of me.
And you get out of hand.
Scared the crap out of me.
Tikataka.
Go on, dog.
Great.
It's usually like just that picture is what we're going at.
I'm just outside. Oh, I'm outside air with some coaches. What do I have to wait on? Oh, of course, I'd have to wait on a milk train.
Oh, it's Callum.
Hi.
It's a foot penis.
No. We're going for opposite. Yeah, foot fanny.
I could have pretended I'm not hearing any of this.
I don't even know what's going on.
You're too young to know.
I am.
I love one minute while.
Go ahead.
And I'll come back to them being pretty fucking just gone.
I am very happy right now.
Kelly time or something?
Because as of yesterday, I have started my holiday.
Hey!
So I am off work until the 18th. So I'm happy. Also, the new radio for my car has arrived today.
Remind me, what car do you have?
It's Talbot Alpine.
Nice!
The radio I've got is really cool. It's a retro look radio, and it's got Bluetooth, SD card.
So basically, it's a retrofitting radio.
Yeah. But the best thing was that it was £15 brand new.
15? Wow.
That's pretty cheap.
It's a steal.
Yeah. And the best bit is that the user manual comes in Chinglish.
Chinglish?
Chinese
what?
English.
Yeah. Let me just read out a little bit so you can get a general idea.
All podcasts in here!
No, that's just
what do you use the manual for? You plug it in, put it in, and get going.
No, but here's the thing. The manual, because it's in Chinglish, is really funny. So, play USB. Please be careful not to crash.
That's rule one of driving.
Yeah, really. Please be careful.
Cause the machine to prevent damage for a long time when not. Remove the USB or SD card. To prevent a short circuit, do not place metal objects, screws, pon-ins, tools, and Opto components falling into the device. To protect the traffic safety, please do not concentrate on driving the process of regulating the product.
That sounds like a QVC product.
In the USB or SD card, please be careful not to other line of wool or hair into the UBS or SD tilting deck to avoid poor syntax.
What? What?
Oh,
I'm glad I never looked at my user manual. I think there was some more in here that's quite funny. Hold on. Oh, yeah. There's a button. It comes with a remote as well. It comes with the remote. God. And one of the buttons is equal loudness. It's hilarious. It is hilarious. What do you think? Oh, unreasonable power. This is in the troubleshooting. Cheese box, make sure there's no short circuit between wires. Repeat ace, the fuse, the same melting capacity auto ignition system, ACC position, the same guide wire connected to the ignition wire as the battery wire. The memory is connected to power lines and power supply positive. That doesn't sound complicated at all, does it?
No, not at all, no. What?
I just found the power supply. Notes this machine.
I'm mad someone got the wrong idea and they start cutting up all their cables for their car.
This machine is 12 volt machine, not according to the 24 volt power supply. So they asked the 24 power volt supply, and asked, is this 24 volt? And they went, no, it's 12 volt, mate.
So in other words,
basically
what that means is you can't put it in a lorry. You can't put it in a big rig. Or a diesel-powered truck, basically.
Hold on, just look at this. Check the telescopic antenna is nominal. Check the antenna input socket is good. With or without contact with the defect.
Break.
Hey, Steven, you were watering the track bed there, mate.
Yeah, no, it's not my fault.
Yeah, Alex, I cannot get that thing to work at all.
Are you driving an American track?
No, he's driving Duke Dog.
That's insanely
disappointing. You're driving me. If I was to be like that, I'd be...
Yeah. I'm driving something big and happy, i.e. something blue.
That doesn't sound like it.
Stuart, what do you think the issue is that we can actually get it to fucking work?
The last time I tried something like that, it worked, but that was Trains 12. I tried the same tactic, doesn't work.
That's annoying.
Oh yeah, because it's a different game, it's scripted differently. Also, Stuart, I'm playing one of your scenarios.
Mm-hmm.
For the tank. I'm liking it.
Wait. I've just checked my subscription. Caledonian Railway 944 class. Has Chris made another loco for Train
7?
Yeah.
Yes, he has.
When did this come out?
Like today.
It's due out at midnight.
When I get paid.
Yeah, pretty much.
Why
always the fighting? Black.
How does he do this? How does he come up with, what was it, two locos, which we had no fucking clue that were coming, and they just suddenly come up?
Well, we had me to do scenarios for him. Let's see what else he had.
Black.
Well, he's got plenty of drawings. He's got Glenn. I'll give him a hand with some sounds, I think.
You know what?
What?
On the subject of development, I think I will go ahead and make this announcement now.
Having trouble coupling up, Stu?
Just a tad. I'm coupled up, but not in a very good way.
Yes, someone else has been having that problem and we don't know what's causing it.
It's the collision detection.
Yeah, the hitbox for the engine pretty much is the problem.
It's only a tad though. It's better than what the Pioneer's was.
It's better than what the 4300 was.
Mm-hmm. You know what? I kind of want that car the end.
Hey, Spets, train fan, be careful here.
Yeah.
Same thing, just a different name. Move on, please.
Oh, jam is jelly and jelly is jello.
Britain and America.
It's the coach. It's the hitbox and the coach.
Two countries separated by common language.
Mm. Sure, it's the hitbox and the coach, Steve.
It is, yeah.
It's equal with the end of the gangway.
Hmm.
Oh, you're right, it is.
You know what? That reminds me of the, the Just Trains V2.
Oh, the V2 is diabolical.
They still haven't patched that.
You had major problems with that, if I remember, during that challenge.
Oh, during that Race of the Dark Railway where I had to use a turntable.
Oh, God.
You technically came second because you did not derail.
That's true. It's true. But yeah, I was just really pissed off. I couldn't run around the train. I couldn't couple anything up to the front. And also, I just noticed, has TS actually received the 64-bit update?
Yeah.
Yes.
Came out earlier.
Walking train syntax is a very interesting image from Granfield.
I'm curious whether TS will... Because I know it needs double the RAM now, but I haven't updated my RAM yet. I haven't had a chance. So I'm wondering if 64-bit will actually work any better with the RAM I've currently got.
Well, if you, assuming you've got a 64-bit operating system, you should be fine.
Well, it's Windows 7. 4-bit.
Windows 7, so you have a 64-bit system, so you're good.
There you go. Hmm. Yeah, I may have, like, less than half the RAM it needs, but fuck it. Anyway, I've had a brilliant day today. Because I also went to see all my local furry mate, and we went to where I work for Carbery. And I made my manager very, very happy because, of course, I just brought in 8 extra customers on Thursday when it's normally dead. So, yeah, I helped give them more money.
What route should I go on now, guys?
One with railway tracks on it.
Yes.
Thank you,
Scott. Hey, that's my normal saying.
Down, you fucked up.
You
can go up the line, round the corner, back again.
Stephen, why don't you try the bluebell?
If he's got it.
Terry's also saying bluebell.
The bell of blue, because why not?
I'm just looking at the YouTube chat. Mr. Train Fan 4014 said, "I am American." Good for you.
No shit.
Yeah, that was part of an earlier discussion that I very rapidly put a pin in. So,
yeah.
Can we just agree that it doesn't matter what country you're from, we are united by railways?
Yes.
However, I will put this statement forward, and this applies to cats and is fucking true. What's mine is mine, and what's yours is also mine.
Millie has stole my chair again with my high heels.
I've got to thank you, Stu, because I came up with something which I thought was very diplomatic, very unified, and then you come out with that.
Was it a plan to steal Tibby?
Anyways,
then again, you probably want to steal him now, don't you?
What, Tibby?
Yes.
Oh, I miss Tibby so much. He was the most affectionate cat in the world.
I'm just going to go out on a limb and say I have to go. Goodbye, guys. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
I have homework.
Speaking of cat, I'm going to see if I can get the squeak. I'll be right back.
Speaking of interesting, a Don Ellis stare just passed me.
Oh. Next!
And I hear a guard's whistle.
I don't, I hear people talking.
Oh, hold on. I hear a signal box.
I am back with a very sleepy squeaky.
Aren't cats always sleepy, though?
Yeah.
It's well, except for...
A very sleepy, talkative squeaky.
Well, do you want to say hi?
Yay!
Hello, Tugol. And my cats are out hunting mice.
He's a squeaky boy, aren't you? You squeaky butt. Yes. My little squeak. You're my squeaky, aren't you?
Ski is the crazy cat guy.
I fed most of them, apart from one.
When you may.
No, Tigger hasn't come back.
The thing is that when you don't see Stu, right, so when he's not on the call, he's literally just out the front going, crazy cat guy.
No. No, he's probably raising a cane and going, you damn kids, get off my lawn.
No, that's old man. No, I'm thinking like Stu crossed with the crazy cat lady from Simpsons.
Oh.
Not that bad. I just get annoyed by this one right here. Mr. DG.
I'm going to disappear off. I'll be back.
Speaking of cats, Maine just popped its head through the door and ran off again.
It's like, oh, nothing happening. Okay, bye.
No, it popped its head through the door, went, oh, fuck it, Ken.
Well, to be fair, that's pretty much what Fleeps' reaction when he first saw him. Well, kinda. In that right, Cam?
Yeah,
Cam was in my armchair. Well, sitting in the armchair. I was sitting on the bed, and the cat came in, the other one. He kind of jumped a wee bit at the fact I was not sitting in the chair.
Cats, I think, are really weird animals. Timmy was really, really affectionate and really quite a lovely cat. He was a beautiful cat. My mate Dale, he's got a cat who is very peculiar. His cat is called Oscar, after Oscar Wilde, because he is a peculiar character. And it's all because he'll come up to me and he'll go, oh, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, fuss me. And I start fussing him, right? I'm fussing him for like, 15, 20 minutes, and then he'll suddenly start biting and scratching my arm.
Then suddenly, attack!
For no reason. Yeah, basically.
What? What is with the dirty looks?
Because you woke him up.
What?
Yeah.
I'll be back in a second again. I need to go look.
She's my seat. You cannot has.
Cats give dirty looks. It's what cats are for.
It's my seat.
Okay.
Yes, it's my seat.
I've just checked the route. See how on the route picker, a quick drives, you've got the top one with the countries. For some reason, Gaming Gnomes comes under Australia.
Also, another thing I've remembered about cats, which is that they produce like, it's kind of like a pheromone, and it triggers off a little thing in your brain, which is weirdly enough addictive, and it makes you really affectionate towards the cat, and it brings across like feelings of anxiety, depression, and all kinds of things. It's why people with loads and loads of cats always end up going mad, is because of this sort of pheromone that the human body picks up off cat. But that's a weird thing, because I don't know whether I'm more of a cat or a dog person, because I've had both, and I can see the plus and negatives of both. Like, for example, cat, pluses, don't have to walk them, they're generally less in your face, they're really independent animals. You can pretty much just leave them to their own devices, and you could just carry on with your life. Great. Whereas dogs are a bit more full on, but I would say that, well, cats are also cleaner, but
they shit in a box.
Well, they're just cleaner animals in general. And besides, Tibby didn't really need a litter box because he always went outside. Tibby was like the best of both a cat and a dog, really.
Then there's this one. He came inside just to use the litter tray to have a shit and then went back outside.
Yeah. I think...
Hey.
That's a present for you. Smell
good.
I just can't work out which is better, actually. Whether a cat is better than a dog or a dog is better. I just can't work it out.
They're both as good, but cats are easier.
Yeah.
Cats are easier to maintain.
But cats are also more evil.
Dogs are... I mean, dogs are a bit more needy. They
are more like a child.
Yeah.
Well, actually, they're both children in their own way. A dog is like a toddler, and a cat is like a teenager.
Yeah. Speaking of which, you guys mentioned evil cat, and guess who shows up?
Shay?
Yes. And he's on my lap watching me drive tank engine horribly.
What locust should I drive on the bell?
Adams Radio?
Fuck it, go with the Adams and Stepney.
Oh. Wait. Either Adams Adventures, Adams and Stepney, or Adams and the new toy that arrived. That'd be even funnier. Because here's the thing, you've got this little tiny radial tank next to this great big massive thing.
What's the performance of the game being for your end, Steve? What's the performance being on your end now that TS is 4-bit?
It is smoother, but it still takes a fucking age to load
as well.
Does it?
Well, if you get a chance, look in Train Sim Pics, bottom picture that Nathan put in. He can actually tell the difference.
Train Sim
Pics. Okay, here you want down. Oh.
One on the left is the 32-bit. Hey, where do you think you're going? Where do you think you're going, Sunshine?
Mike,
what do you think you're doing?
He wants food.
It's on the fucking table my keyboard sits on! Hey, get off the keyboard! Get off the keyboard!
Maybe he wants to send a message.
Get off the fucking keyboard!
Yeah, like we have done before.
What, you want me to move stuff for you so you can have a sit down?
Think you have a sit?
Did you order some sits? Is this what it is? Is this your sits ordering?
I think it's fucking on the table!
Why do I see blue light?
No idea.
You know what, fuck it, I'm putting this in banner. This is... this cat, seriously.
So...
you and your...
Steve, when you're talking about the different... So, it's a bottom picture and train sim pic.
Yeah.
And the one on the left is 32-bit, is it?
Yeah, the one on the left is 32.
Colours are a bit different, aren't they?
Yeah.
Should I have it in spring, summer, autumn, or winter?
Why not? Winter.
Well, it's autumn, so I would probably go mid evening when you got the sun starting to come down and making everything all orangey and gorgeous.
Oh Christ! What time is that going to be? Because TS does it a lot differently from real life because it doesn't do it properly.
Now, if we look in banter...
Try... 5:30.
What?
That's the table my keyboard sits on, and the cat has claimed it.
No, Steve, just in that photo one, you can see how it's not Stuart Schwimmer's.
My room's smaller.
Yeah, a lot smaller.
Here's the thing, guys. Cats are arseholes.
No, he's just evil. Yes, you are. Don't lie.
Meow. Cat's not saying anything, dude.
Let's see.
Last time he tried to get on this table, he fell on his arse.
Don't know, Stuart, but it looks like that mouse is about to go somewhere really inappropriate.
Well, they didn't stick around for long.
I thought just move the fucking keyboard out of his way.
Why do you think the cat isn't allowed on my desk?
So, I'm just curious, why was the Caledonian Pacific tank known as Super Pug?
Well, it's not known as Super Pug, it was known as the Weems Pug.
Like a pug.
Well, pug for a in Cali days was any tank engine. It's generally associated with 040s, but it can apply to any tank engine.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Meow. I'm just thinking. I'm going to wait until I get my paycheck, then I think I'm going to buy 404.
You've got two. Well, there are two scenarios in it for you to get familiar with the engine.
I do like the fact it has got a couple of PR over it. Even though it is a good one.
Mainly because they were withdrawn, and well, the last one went in 53.
Yeah. It's a bit of an oddball course, I've got to say. It's a bit of an oddball course for local DLC, but it's a really interesting lifetime. Not for me, but anyway, so.
I really don't think it is an oddball choice.
Oh, that's better.
Fucking hell.
You feel better?
A little bit.
I'm guessing he does.
No, check your pants and make sure there's no hole.
Oh, fuck. I think I need to open a window.
That sounded like you followed through.
Nah, I ain't followed through.
Oh, I almost did that once. It was terrible.
What, shut yourself?
No, I almost followed through.
I've never had a thought follow through. You can always tell if you've had a follow through because you look at your pants, it's like pebble dash.
Oh.
Sounds like experience, really, secretly.
Squeak, do you mind?
Wow.
Yes,
no, you don't mind.
Meow.
Meow, 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 meow,
possible.
Okay.
What?
My.
What have you done?
Have you broken it?
Everything's done.
Oh, it crashed!
Hey! Steven, that was an hour and a half.
What have you done?
And do you know why it went?
Why?
Access thing.
Access violation.
What does that even mean?
We don't know.
The guard will tell us in a minute.
Joseph, I'm tempted to write a note to Dovetail and say, oi, dumbasses.
What does this mean?
What does this access violation crap mean?
Was it like, you're not allowing me permission to run the fucking game?
The game crashed.
Because it's for point
of content.
Yeah,
it did.
Squeaky butt. Hi.
Hence why I've got the contacted no help support on.
I'm actually just messing around on a little branch line.
Guys!
Yeah? Mm.
Mine crashed.
I knew it wouldn't last for long.
No, do you know what I got?
What?
I just got temped up.
So you didn't get an access violation. You didn't get an access violation. You just got a normal dump.
It took a shit.
Yeah, it took the shit.
And then Discord just took a shit.
Tamagotchi. That's what yours is.
I used to have one of them.
Tamagotchi.
I've got mine near somewhere.
What was the other one where it was like the cubes where you had a person in it? What were those?
The what one?
It's like a cube that you had, and you had like You know, you could get a fitness one, you could get a musician one, and loads of other, like, dudes. And basically, like, you could have, like, a mini game on it, and you could have the two of them interact with each other. It was kind of like Tamagotchis, only it was a dude guy, or something. Like a stick figure.
Heard that.
Not sure.
I wouldn't know. I don't have a clue.
I was just asking open to see if anyone actually knew what it was.
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
Yeah, sorry.
You know, I know that Tamagotchi, that was the girl's boy with the like little pet animal thingy.
Yeah.
Look,
yeah,
Tamagotchi?
I wouldn't say it was explicitly for girls. So
they were all the rage in the 90s.
Oh yeah.
And very early 2000s.
I remember them more for the early 2000s. In fact, I also remember Game Boy Colors.
I've got my Game Boy Color, I've got my Game Boy Advance, I've got the SP, I've got them.
Yeah, I've still got the original Game Boy. I still have the big gray brick.
I've never had a Game Boy.
I can't remember what happened to that one of mine. I think I lost it. But I could have it somewhere.
I've never had a games console, I've never had a handheld game either.
Fuck yeah. Hmm?
I tried to eat my Game Boy when I was young. I was young when it came out.
What, like two?
What are you doing?
The games consoles, you name it, I've had. Or got. Somewhere.
Yes, two.
I think this is the thing, because I was never raised around games. I always looked sort of like me and my brother.
Including the Nintendo 64.
Me and my brother, we'd often make up our own game, make up our own things to do, and I think that's what made us quite creative, really.
Mm-hmm.
We used to go down the local burn and make up a dam. We used to, what else did we used to do? We used to mess about with the turkeys, you know, get them to chase us, and then just stand completely still and watch in amazement as they sort of go, where did they go? So, they're not the most intelligent animals, turkeys.
Based on movement.
Yeah, entirely, that's the thing. Like, you know, me and my brother, we'd run into the, we'd start running about, and the turkeys would go, oh, there's something moving, I better go towards it. Run towards it, you know, chase after us. They would just stand completely still, and they go,
what is this?
I wonder if that's where they got the idea for T-Rex's sight.
That might be the thing, yeah.
Despite the fact we have no idea how a T-Rex's sight mechanic, well, let's say mechanic, sight system worked.
They did have binocular vision.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
so I think they were more opportunistic hunters than anything.
I think it's because like dinosaurs, like they evolved eventually into birds, didn't they? Yeah, I think that the theory goes that
T-Rexes had feathers.
Mm-hmm. Not feathers, more along the lines of proto feathers.
See, here's the thing. I don't really like the idea of, you know, feathered dinosaurs.
The raptors, I can see, but some of the bigger ones, I can't really.
When I found out that dinosaurs were actually supposed to be covered in feathers, I was just sort of like, well, that's kind of ruined Jurassic Park and Land Before Time as well.
Yeah, really.
Well, to be quite honest, I probably wouldn't put it past it that the. Like some of the dinosaurs, if not all the dinosaurs, had some sort of like fur or feathers on them. Because you've got to think, all those millions and millions and millions of years ago, the climate was a lot different than what it is now. I mean, it was a hell of a lot colder back then.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with the Ice Age.
Mm.
That is true. So.
Well, that said, they were bigger animals, so they could generate more body heat.
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily.
That's the thing. We don't know whether or not if these things were warm-blooded or cold-blooded or not. So,
well, if a lot of them are related to birds, then it could be assumed that they were closely related to... Well, that they could have been warm-blooded. Like, velociraptors, I could see them being warm-blooded because, of course, raptors evolved into, like, birds of prey and whatnot. So I could see, you know, them being warm-blooded. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know about that. I think it all depends when the dinosaurs lived, because of course the climate did change depending on where they were back then as well. And there were some hot bits, and there were some like colder bits as well.
Oh.
I kind of want a time machine, so I'm just going to go back to the dinosaur period and just piss off T-Rex.
Oh, before dear it is- God. The Onion actually did a very accurate news piece. All right, now hold on. Hold on. Are you guys ready for this? Piece? Are you guys ready for this?
No.
Toddler junkie immediately hooked on looking at trains after first exhilarating high.
That's
fucking accurate, right?
yeah.
That sounds accurate to a T.
Yeah. For once, The Onion actually reported a reliable piece of news.
Also, this kind of proves Steven's point. Okay? This
we
proves
like trains.
Steven's point. No. That get a child hooked on trains early, they'll have no money for drugs and alcohol.
That's kind of true, because, you know, the way the whole trains...
Yeah, if they don't like trains and they get fucking drugs, they get lose their fingers.
You know what? Here's the thing, right? I've just thought of this, which is that in a few years' time, right, I imagine the Hornby stuff will get so expensive, or model trains will just become so outrageously weird that it becomes completely outlawed, and you just got people on street corners like, "Oi, mate, got any smoky joke?"
I'm getting so
old. Oh, dear God.
What? I'm just picturing Callum in a trench coat, his pockets rattling with various conditions of Smokey Joe's, just flagging down random kids like,
Uncle Smokey Joe got original 1988 release.
Black Fives up the wazoo.
If you give me 10 grand, right, you give me 10 grand, I'll give you the 2800 here with working smoke generator.
Deal. I'm sold.
I'm just imagining a world where railway enthusiasts would have to end up, like, you know, snorting Hornby smoke oil, you know, or something like that.
Oh, for God's sake.
Yeah, go to the street corner and go, "Hey, mate, have you got the dashes I asked for?"
You get your baby, buddy. You get you get the stuff, right? You get the stuff, right?
Yeah, I got the stuff. You got the money?
Yeah. Give me any of my fix, mate.
Hello. What's going on in here then?
All right, mate.
It's a buzz.
Oh shit! No Gloucester for you, bite.
This is run away. Oh my God! Why can I see that? Why can I see this being such a perfect scale?
Oh, dude, I got a high off this track magic, man.
One way to solve it. We have to clear up all the drug dealers right now.
Hold on. I've got the perfect solution to this, guy.
Oh, boy.
There's a credit card machine that needs money to work. It says... Credit card denied. You have enough trains already.
There's no one way to solve it. We'll move. We'll move from the land, and we burn this one down.
To be fair, I think that's what Stevens will say to him at one point.
What?
Credit card. Your debit card has been declined. You've got too many model trains.
I went bullshit, asshole. I don't have too many.
My credit card. Both of my cards kept declining today, even though I only just put money on them. But they kept declining today, and I can only think it's because it's like, "Oh, look, don't you think you're spending a little bit too much money on your credit card?"
Bring it to you.
Also, okay. The model stops and starts fucking crying.
Also, I picked up when I was coming back from Birmingham yesterday. I found what's it? Well, I found a copy of Metro on a table, the train, and there was an article in here which kind of made me giggle when I saw it, which is. The bloke who was responsible for the Salisbury poisoning. His cover, his cover was blown by his grandmother. Who was proudly, and I do mean proudly, showing pictures of the spy in question receiving an award of Cupid.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Yeah, you know.
Also, I'm liking the Torak car. What's up with the text on that restaurant car? Why is it so broken?
And it is, of course, 6690. I'm not saying names. You can guess who it is. Doc. Classic Waltz.
I'm looking at that. Well, I'm guessing that the bluebell route is very intensive.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's probably why it's going to be a bit stuttery. But you know what? That's kind of the biggest mistake of the bluebell. It's been a route that people have been waiting for a while, because it is quite an iconic preservation route.
It is.
The biggest problem with it is that you require about £3 million worth of DLC in order to run.
Even with 64, it's still better than 6.
Yeah.
I literally just said that.
Alex.
I'm playing Overwatch in the background.
Alex, I was about to say, Alex, I took the Weems tank over the Bluebell. Mm. And that thing was stuttering around Horsted Kings and King's Coat. Mm. And that was just coming into the platforms. Mm. Sharpsword Tunnel was the worst. It just dropped about 10 frames a second while I was in the fucking tunnel. I'm like, how the shit did it drop that hard?
I'm curious as to what all the different disc types mean, Steve. I was wondering if you could explain that to me. Like, why is there a round one, square one, a diamond one?
It's to do with destination codes.
Mm-hmm. That's the thing, I've only ever seen the round ones.
Yeah, because the round ones were mainly a Southern and Brighton thing.
Yeah.
LSWR had all these fancy destination codes.
Yeah.
Because they were special.
Well, also, it was for the signalman, it was an easy way for them to identify which train was which, where it was bound, stuff like that.
The North British had an even better system for identifying what train was going where.
Really?
You had the fucking name of the destination on the top of the boiler, or the top of the smoke wall.
Ah, alright.
There's something else as well. I have been meaning to get the Terrier neck for quite a while.
Get it. It's worth it.
Oh, yeah.
Don't get the one from the Steam store, because that's not even a quarter of what you can get.
fairly even.
That's the thing, because what puts me off is the fact that there's, like, there's too many versions to get, there's too many packs to get the whole shebang.
There's only three packs.
Yeah, but the thing is, though, is that I don't really want the early years pack.
Then don't get it.
You need the early years pack.
Why do you need the early years pack?
Because that's the base pack.
No. You got the base pack, the early years pack, and the later years, haven't you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You just need the main pack to run in the
book. Because that's the thing. I mean, I'm mostly interested in my later stuff. But the thing is that they fucked up with all the liveries on it. Because the later years add-on, that had loads of... that had a couple of pre-grouping liveries and, of course, the Great Western liveries as well. Wouldn't it have made more sense to have the Great Western liveries in the early years pack?
Yes and no.
Really. Yes and no.
Because the Great Western, they were only came into Great Western ownership in 1940.
Mm-hmm.
The two that were sold there. Well, taken over by the Great Western, shall we say.
Yes.
Let's see, they were at the Portishead before that. And then the Great Western bought the Portishead out, and then they got the Terriers.
Yeah.
Funnily enough, Portishead herself actually became Newton Abbott's shed pilot at one point.
Yep.
I'm just thinking, well, Tom that fellow just said that there's an ultra-pack of all the add-ons for Terrier in there. And the more I'm thinking about it, the more I'm thinking, you know what? I'm looking at all this DLC that I'm going, oh, that looks nice, I might buy that. And I'm just thinking, yeah, I'm trying to burn money. But I'm going to resist. I'm going to put all the money basically towards my car, because literally all my car needs is the welding and the paint. That's it. There's welding and paint. Heck, I've even bought centre caps for the wheels and stickers so that you can make the wheels look like they're older, basically.
Nice.
If you go on eBay and there's a firm that does like a set of four Talbot stickers, and you can have them in either the red and blue or the black and silver. And I've gone for red and blue to give that possible the colours. Hmm. I would like a sunstrip over the windscreen with Talbot on it. That'd be cool. Proper retro as well. Oh, I just remembered something else.
I forgot. How do I change the discs and that on the Terrier? How do I change them, like the configuration where I want them?
It's control 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Well, it's having fucking none of it.
Is it just pressing 8?
Try shift. No, shift is the camera, sorry.
It's control 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 0. Could also depend on what way you're facing.
Mm-hmm.
Unless it came in that time where, with the Victory West project, where you can change the destination, well, the head code was in the scenario editor.
No.
Oh, wait, no, that's just trains' configuration, isn't it?
That's just trains' stuff.
There is one engine where you have to change one thing in the editor that it is a Victory Works product. That's the counties with the headboards.
Sorry if you're hearing loads of plastic, but I bought myself a box of space as well, of electrical connectors. It cost me £8, and I bought this because it worked out better than buying two or so packs of connectors from Halfords, or House Frauds, as I like to call them. It's like £1.70 for three connectors. Get fucked.
No thanks, that's a bit steep.
It is.
Especially seeing as Halfords, they don't know what the fuck they're doing. Also, hold on, I've just opened this, and there's a bit of wire in one of these. Bit of wire.
Sorry?
How did that get?
Oh, here we go. We've been ages to change from lamp to disc.
No, we're leaving now. Well, that hasn't been seen since the 80s.
Well, probably never be seen again.
No.
Well, it will be seen again, just static display only.
What? It's like Stepney fucked.
Stepney's been fucked for a while.
Not only... And the Adams has been quite royally fucked for a long time.
Yeah, how bad was the Adams radio, by the way?
It just needs a new boiler, from what I know. If it, wasn't there something to do with the wheels as well, Steve?
Some of them are cracked.
Needs new boiler, wheels, and frames.
No, the frames are fine.
Frames are fine. It's just, from what I understand, it's boiler, some of the wheels are cracked, tyres, and just a generally heavy overhaul.
Oh, do these tyres go to quick fit?
No, not shit fit.
Oh yeah, because quick fit, what they were doing, they were upcharging to fill your tyres with nitrogen, weren't they? Was it hydrogen?
Speaking of upcharge, I got a funny story to tell you guys.
Go ahead.
Whilst I was getting my... whilst I was getting my beloved little GMC Canyon serviced, I was talking to one of the salesmen at the Ford, at the dealership I went to, and they had a Raptor there, and we were talking about the Raptor. I was kind of like, okay, the Raptor's a cool truck and all. Then I don't know what brought it up, but he said, yeah, let me tell you a little something, buddy. The upcharge on that truck is stupid. The dealership I was at was charging $10,000 over sticker price for that truck. Because everybody wants a Raptor, and Ford limits production, ergo, they can charge whatever the hell they want.
Hold on, well, here's the thing, because the Raptor, that's basically the F-150.
Yeah, the F-150 with a supercharged, tuned, high-performance engine.
Well, you've basically got a vehicle there where they sell a new one every 30 seconds, right? That's how frequently it sells. So obviously there's quite a lot of demand for that type of vehicle. That's probably why they've been upcharged. Because they know that people will want it. Therefore, if people want it, then they can upcharge on it if people really want it that
bad. Well, I mean, it's not just the F1. It's not the F-150 in general. It's just the Raptor. The Raptor is the one that's getting the upcharge. There's another dealership that was less than a quarter mile down the road.
Well, again,
upcharging by 15.
Well, again, it's a vehicle that everybody wants. So, of course, they can upcharge. It's an F-150, right, which is already a desirable vehicle. Then it's a high performance version of the F-150, so that makes it more desirable. Basically, the more desirable something is, the more they can upcharge.
Exactly. Demand will always outweigh supply.
Oh yeah.
Even though I'm not sure how that works for the F-50, because they've made so many over the years. You know what? I'm looking at this big box of connectors that I bought, and I think that the £8 did quite well, though I'm not sure I'm ever going to need the 20 amp.
Keep it just in case.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know that for the radio installation, I will need the 5 and 10 amp stuff, but yeah, not a, what was it, 15 amp?
And the cat's fallen in the bath.
Yeah.
And someone's asking, where's Tom?
What?
No one cares.
And misspelling Steven's name.
I don't think that Tom is available at the moment. He's
probably working again.
Yeah, he's recently come off sickie, and he's been working quite hard again. I've been struggling to get keep up with him as well.
Oh dear.
You've got to remember as well that Tom has a lot of early starts, so he's probably in bed at the moment.
I'm doing a quick drive, and it seems the Great Central have pinched Evening Star.
How's this for a sight, guys?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
with the one green coach in there.
Bitch. Alright, bitch, come here.
It's better with all maroon with just one blood and custard in the middle of it.
Well, this is blue belt, so everything. And of course, having it in the autumn evening as well is producing some fruit.
Ah, that's a beautiful scene.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, there's one route which I'm struggling to get working properly, and that's the Seven Valleys route. I can't get the ground textures or the track to show up.
You've got the safety pressures in there.
I don't know whether it's because I need Portsmouth Direct or not, but I'm pretty sure the Portsmouth Direct is only for Angel.
Bluebell?
No, for Seven Valley.
Oh, for Seven Valley? I can't remember what exactly was needed for it.
I've basically got everything it needs apart from Portsmouth Direct.
Do you mind? I'm trying to click stuff and you're clicking it for me!
He's helping. Well, my cat used to do that. Whenever I was working on the car, like changing the exhaust or the oil filter or whatever, right, Tibby was always coming over, he was going, I want to help. See, are you glad that you listened to me about the lighting?
Oh, if you can see this, Callum, what do you think?
It looks gorgeous, doesn't it? See? Autumn in late evening. That's what you want, with the orangey sun and the orangey leaves.
And the orangey engine.
Exactly. Well, you say orangey engine, that's supposed to be a green engine.
It was green to the colourblind man.
Yeah.
Good thought. No, sure.
Stroudly.
What the, I don't understand how Stroudly could, you know, design the livery when he was colourblind.
You can't doubt him, can you? Because, well, to be fair, he did do a quite nice livery.
Yeah.
It doesn't look half bad, yeah.
Do I know what I'm talking about when it comes to lighting in the game? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What can I say? I'm just, quite frankly, brilliant.
Most of the time.
Now just comes a multiplayer mod.
Oh, I really want multiplayer. Yes, I really do. I think it'd be great fun.
I'm just waiting to see if someone's going to do the same thing like they would do with Trucker's MP.
I honestly think that would be the way to go about executing.
No.
Why not, Cam?
Well, yes and no. I can see advantages and disadvantages.
Personally, I think it would work better if it was the sort of like the way that Trains New Era is done, but it's not restricted to payware Steam DLC.
Yeah, because here's what I'm thinking too. Because think about it like this. If you have, you could have it either be an open lobby or a lobby that's private.
Yeah,
here's the thing.
You know what you just said there, what basically I said that TS would work as. Like, for example, you can have, like, for example, like, multiplayer scenarios, if you will, where you have, like, loads of engines, they've all got their own construction.
Pretty much like free run.
Well, not quite. Well, that's another side of it, but basically, like, you know, a multiplayer scenario, obviously, like, you have, like, a set number of events with orders and whatnot, and basically, you and a bunch of mates have to work on getting the trains running. You're going to have a scenario where someone has to shunt a train while someone is preparing another engine to take that train onwards to wherever people have to obey signals. If one person is late, that affects everybody else. So basically, it has to become a team effort to make sure that everybody manages to get everything done on time, effectively. And then you've got the free roam, which I can see like that working as an open lobby thing where people just go in, they click on the engine they want and drive it back. I can see that work. Definitely. I want to have a situation where, like, having a multiplayer scenario over Woodhead, for example, and needing to back people up from whack up to Paniston.
Yeah. You know, something like that would be nice.
Yeah.
We'll have to wait and see.
You can have someone like someone down at WAC yard organise the train, and whoever is supposed to be taking the train onward in the meantime while they're waiting starts banking people up to Penistone, and then they come back down, take their train, go onwards, you know, someone's got another train down, they help bank up and so on, basically people taking turns and banking.
Yeah.
I can see that working. And then you've got people running past the train from Manchester to Sheffield. And yeah, I just think that would be interesting. Weirdale and Teasdale would be absolutely perfect for multiplayer.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely perfect. That route was designed for multiplayer, as far as I'm concerned, anyway. Because there are so many places to start from, so many yards, so many things to do. It's a really good route for that sort of thing. You can have someone managing the branch lines, someone managing the yard, someone managing... You know, you can have everybody... You know, I have a big group of friends all doing something.
Oh yeah.
I mean, that'd be great. If we had like a multiplayer on that, then I would just be in the Q6 just driving about like, hey, does anybody want to push? You know, or just, hey, has anyone got any car wagons or want to go to the power station?
It's like I'm just hiding with a Weems. I'm in the yard with a Weems tank. Yeah, there's 50 of them told them my dog cost 6.
Heck, you could even have like a competitive element to it as well. Like, you can have team versus team. So sort of like with War Thunder or whatnot, where basically like, say, you have a group of people who represent one shed of engines and then another group of people who represent another shed. And basically you have to get as many objectives done in a certain amount of time, for example.
My route would be perfect for that. Because I've got 3 sheds.
But I'm also thinking, like, you know, even like a region thing, like, I'm just trying to think of, like, a part of the country where it would just be like multiple, like, railway companies operating. Probably, Wickham and John. Because that was shared. A lot of that was shared between Southern and Great Western. The worst Southern locos went as far down as Oxford. You can have like scenarios where, you know, you've got Southern engines, Great Western engines operating in that one bit, and they have to get as many objectives done, say, within a 2-hour period as possible, with as few mistakes as possible. So run it like a career scenario, but make it competitive. I could see that working. The sheds also used to compete against each other, didn't they?
Yeah, they did.
But that would be fun. I think that would be really good fun.
Mm-hmm. I can almost see that being a thing with, like, and Stephen and Co might agree with me on this, with our role plays where we each, like, drop an engine in for a contest to see who can do the best. Because I think, don't some preserved railways compete with each other as well?
I think so, yeah. Well, all I think is that, you know, with all these ideas for multiplayer that we're coming up with, right, Matt Heddleston, are you watching?
No. I don't think he will be.
Nah.
Because we slag DTG off too much.
Yeah.
And rightly so.
To be fair, with DTG, they spent so much bloody effort on Train Sim World, and what you've ended up with is a train simulator that falls in the uncanny valley, where you can't derail, where you can't really have fun, and you also...
There's no steam engine.
No steam engine, then there probably never will be. There isn't any multiplayer in it, even though it was one of the things when they said, oh yeah, it's possible for us to put in multiplayer.
They will.
Yeah. The routes are all bloody short. And it's just useless.
And, in the case of the Great Western Main Line, shorter than the original.
Yeah,
and I have a very good suspicion why.
Why?
Didcot. Exactly. If they had made it to the length of the original, they would have had to put Didcot Railway Centre in there.
Yeah.
And I bet you, if they had done that, they would have put the fucking gas turbine thing in. As a matter of fact, what diesels do Didcot have that isn't the Gronks?
Rail cars.
The rail cars.
Yeah, the flying bananas. Yeah.
Railway centre.
Yes, we see.
Diesel locomotives. Yeah, flying banana, Hunslet, Gronk, Teddy, gas turbine.
But the gas turbines haven't run in years, have they?
Exactly.
Shame.
Because, I mean, Didcot's got a really good collection of steam engines from different eras of the Great Western and British Railways.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I think they're missing broad gauge.
No, they have broad gauge.
Don't they have a... I was going to ask.
Yeah, Firefly's there.
And Iron Duke. Remember, they're trying to restore that.
Oh. Mm-hmm. I was going to ask. Don't they have a standard gauge running section at Didcot?
Yeah, they're standard they got, and broad.
Yeah, they've got two standard gauge demonstration lines and a broad gauge, which is dual gauge because the standard runs in the middle of it.
Ah!
Which is how the Great Western was originally. They used to run dual gauge for a while, didn't they?
Yeah.
Up until the very early 1900s, I believe.
And how? I mean, I'm just trying to remember because it was a really quick time converting everything. Broad gauge to standard gauge, it was like something ridiculous, like 80 hours or something.
I think it was something like, what was it? I don't think it was even 2 weeks, was it?
No, I think it was measured in hours. That's how quick they were.
Yeah.
Who's that?
You know what? That'd be actually quite interesting to try and simulate in the game as well. To try and simulate like the mixed gauge era of the Great Western.
Yeah, that was just broad gauge.
Nah, but here's the thing: because they ran dual gauge for a lot of the time, I think that'd be quite difficult to just implement. Where it's just tiny.
It would also be difficult to implement the dual gauge system.
Yeah.
Dual gauge for what?
No, just it would be difficult to run dual gauge on TS because, I mean, you'll probably know where I'm going with this. We kind of already have dual gauge in TS.
Yes.
Albeit a very short portion.
Yeah.
Clear Creek, right?
Mm-hmm. And yeah. That's only configured for the 3 foot gauge running.
That's the thing, you can't really configure it, can you?
You can't configure it properly. Trains, on the other hand, you can. Only because that was built differently.
You can do dual gauge TS track wise, but
just very
consist wise, you can't. But actually, it's not as hard as you're thinking of it. It's just a matter of lining up track. I do it all the time.
But the thing is that you've got to think about like doing a route where it's all sort of like that. Well, saying that though, I wouldn't be surprised if like a firm like Victory Works couldn't find a way to do it, like basically making almost like a 2-in-1 lot of dual gauge track.
That'd be nice.
Because they worked out water troughs, didn't they? So I imagine that they've got the capabilities. Yeah,
they worked their water troughs because DTG weren't bothered.
Oh, this is amusing.
I think that the water troughs are brilliant because it's literally just a marker and you just put a trough on top of it to mark out where it is.
The strange thing is, it's taken them so long. Because, I mean, MSTS has had that since it released in the early 90s?
Yeah.
Late 90s? Mm. And it's taken them until 2016, so possibly 16, 18 years.
Well, this is the thing, because Victory Works started life as Karma 99, and they started off doing, what was it, MSTS converts, didn't they? So
he made his own stuff. He did the Q1 as freeware originally.
Yep. Isn't he His
first payware was the 5600, which was the first engine to have simulated chest blowouts, like you can blow the pistons.
Yeah. Wasn't it also the first with a reversal lock?
I think so.
Yes, it was.
And it was. And a simulated ejector as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you look at him now, I mean, Christ.
TPO has been added in. Wardrops have been added in.
Yeah. I mean, hell.
Auto trains have been added in.
Yeah. That's... I mean, hell, if we... Even act, looking at...
Active guard.
Active guard
as well. Peter VictorWorks has given us more than
enough.
We realize.
Yeah. And that's kind of, and also, you know, I mean, if you think about it and look at it like this, too. We have Chris, too, who's given us countless engines that nobody's ever thought of making, or people have had no interest in making. I mean, for Christ's sake, he was only just talking about a long boiler being in TES, and now look at what we've got.
Never had a Caledonian engine apart from Freeware, and then we end up with a whole race of payware Caledonian engines, where all they need is a suitable era route to run on.
Yeah.
Well, all the BR ones can run on Port Road, but that's enough.
Oh yeah, all the BR ones can run on Port Road. Well, some of them anyway, but I've found difficulty trying to allocate particular locos in the shed.
Such as?
Well, the Cali Pugs, for instance, because they were nowhere near on the Port Road, as far as I'm aware. There was a large brace of them at Motherwell. And there was even a couple in Shrewsbury, weirdly enough, 40 miles away from where I live.
Well, if you think that's bad, there was one at the same shed as Bertha.
Oh yeah, so there was.
Bromsgrove.
Yeah, yeah.
There was another at Preston.
Yeah, I think there was a couple at Preston.
There was a few at Crewe.
Yeah, Crewe Works ended up having them. I think there's a work shunter.
Yeah. That was actually the last one to be scrapped.
Until they were completely fucked, and then they just withdrew them and cut them up.
I think Chris would be the best person to make Bertha.
Well, didn't you say you found something for Bertha, Stuart?
There are drawings for it.
I think the thing is with Big Bertha is that...
There's nowhere to run her as of yet, but...
There's a freeway...
Someone's working on it.
There's a freeway route with Licky Incline, but... It's not
the best.
No, it's very defaulty, and it's also got ridiculous tight corners. Don't want to brag on the route too much, because someone actually went ahead and actually did it, where you could drive Manchester, Sheffield, Derby, Birmingham, basically. But I still really... The one thing that I want, top of my list of routes, would be a Cambrian network, basically. So that'd be fantastic.
Yeah.
You can have it, like, you know, start at Shrewsbury, you can have it go to, Aberystwyth, obviously Ulster Street, because that was the heart of the Cambrian network. You could probably even incorporate the Welshful and Transfer in there as well. The line that ran through Llangollen, so on. I think, you know, having a Cambrian network would be fantastic. You could probably even end up with a whole... like Welsh railway network. Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
I'd say Talithlin and Corus and Helm,
yeah.
The Vale of Rydal.
You know what I'd like to see is like having, and I don't know if it would be possible in TS, I know it's possible in trains, but having like a transfer system between the standard.
I would like to see, like, definitely like the Welshful Transfer incorporated into a Cambrian, because
Great Western.
Well, it was Cambrian.
Yeah,
it was all Cambrian. In fact, the Welshful Transfer even counts as British Railways.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's
good one. Albeit they didn't really run any trains.
Another route I'd like to see, and maybe in a Tay Day or whatever. the Welsh Highland?
You've got that as freeware.
Yeah.
But, saying that though, you mentioned that.
It's pretty decent freeware.
It is decent freeware, but also, I'm just thinking as well, like the North Wales Narragate Railway network, back in its heyday.
Mm-hmm.
The Beth Alert and the Fairleys and their original construction, and the George England's and their original construction, and so on.
Yeah.
I think that'd be quite interesting to see.
I'd like... This is just a long shot and a wish in a bucket, but I'd love to see the Snowdon Mountain Railway made.
Snowdon would be interesting.
It would be interesting, though, saying that, though, scenario-wise, probably not the most. Drive to the top of Snowdon. Drive back down again. Drive to the top of Snowdon. Drive back down again. You know.
Rescue abandoned train. Retrieve the wreckage of number one.
Crash number one. I mean, honestly, it would be... It's something.
It would be interesting to see if, like, maybe in the future, someone can actually, like, if there was, like, a recreation of that first run, where basically you reach a particular marker, and then, like the aeroplane in that picture, in that Q1 scenario, you could probably have, like, an engine actually come off the track and plummet down the mountainside.
Yeah.
If you scripted it well enough.
Yeah.
Is durable. Oh, well, I can imagine it's durable. It's using a separate model, like, you know, having like a stop instruction or go by instruction, where the, you know, the engine gets to end the scenario, and then it finishes off with a little scripted animation thing.
Yeah, scripted cinematic. Yeah.
You just have to be clever with where you put your cinematic cameras. Do it.
Yeah.
I think we've got to the point there. Oh, pardon me. In TS where you can pretty much simulate most trains that have run, like, ever, pretty much.
Yeah.
Especially with some of the turntables I've found.
Oh, yeah. I mean, hell, we even have a 1920s route here. What's wrong?
What? Game's frozen. Game's frozen. Oh, there it goes again.
Yeah, it sometimes does that. Right, where's the timetables? Here we go. Because the ones I've got the Aberdonian, Lakes Express, Midday Scot, Northumbrian, Royal Scot, Scarborough Flyer, Thames Clyde, the Devonian, and the Waverley.
Hmm.
I'm just trying to think what other routes would be interesting to see. I mean, obviously, like, you know, steam era is what we're interested in.
Yeah, I'm trying to think.
That's a steam era settled Carlisle.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Especially with the horse branch.
Isn't that what Stainmore basically is?
It's got part of it, but not... But the only bit it's got is Appleby.
But still, it... Oh, back in the heyday, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That would
or,
be
or even the full extent of the proposal to reopen the whole route.
Well, I think that... Linton and Barton in its heyday, I think...
No.
I think that the LMB would be certainly doable to do in its heyday, because they only have two classes of engine, as far as I'm aware.
Yeah, they had Lin and the things that Lid is.
Well, they had, well, yeah, they had the, I think it was a Baldwin, wasn't it?
Lynn.
Yeah, that Lynn was, and then everything else were planning Walden. So,
based off what Lynn is.
Yeah. Well, I'm not sure if there was another engine guy, that's...
Well, it was a preserved railway, yes.
Yeah, and it's caused much wibble from cities who come moving to the countryside.
And Chris Eden Green put the argument to bed pretty swiftly, I'd say.
Mm-hmm.
What argument?
About the Disneyfication of the railway?
Yeah, the Disneyfication of railways.
Well, the bitch who wouldn't sell the land was just being...
Well, they didn't want to.
He was
Ben.
Absolutely unreasonable. Hello.
Ben.
Yes.
I see you've been doing magic tricks and science books.
Motherfuckers were talking shit, I made them eat shit.
Oh, no, no.
Another thing also, about London to Barnstable.
Yes.
There are plans for another new build. I say new build, more replica.
What, so like a replica of an engine that
Yeo. Yeo.
Ah.
Right, I'm trying to see if I can get the original route.
I just want to have a little look to see what the original loco was.
There was Yeo, and I think there was a couple more.
There was Tor. Yeah, Tor and one other.
Oh, I was going to say, Sped.
Is the gauge of the Lytton Barnstable slimmer or wider than the
I think it's
smaller. It's about the same as the Custiniog.
Which is 2 foot.
1 foot 11.5 inches, I think.
Well, the actual gauge, I think, for the... Hang on, let's see. It says here. 11 foot?
1 foot 11.5.
1 foot 11.625. So there's not much difference. What?
Apparently there's 2 year builds.
So they're doing both.
Terry is running down into the mess room.
Yeah, Festiniog is 1 foot 11.5.
Mm. Which chat?
Stream chat.
Down here.
Hang on.
Yeah, there was...
UX, Tor, and Lou.
Festiniog and Linton can essentially swap engines.
They have. Lynn went to the Welsh Highland not that long ago, and now Lyd is at the. Is now at the London and Barnstable.
What about an engine like. What about the railway like the Leighton Buzzard?
Maybe.
Now this is the interesting thing about Lou, because Lou went off to Brazil,
and we don't know if it was scrapped or not.
No, there's no identification of that engine whereabouts. Like what happened to it or anything.
Lake Buzzard actually has one of Douglas's sisters there, doesn't it?
No. If you put a picture in, I'll be able to tell you.
Oh, I just thought of something else that would be cool to train to, like the 3 foot navigation network in Ireland. That'd be interesting.
What about the
Isle of Man
steam railway?
Yeah, the Isle of Man steam railway. Well, I think the Isle of Man network would definitely be doable. But I think County Donegal would be really interesting.
What about Australian railways? Because they've got narrow gauge, standard, and broad.
Yeah, like the puffing billy.
Yeah, well, also, think about it like this, guys. If we do get Australian railways...
I know the first thing that someone's going to demand. No, Scotsman.
No. Let me finish.
No, the Touring Railway Hudson R-Class.
Let me finish.
I'm surprised it's a very old
one. Yeah, Late Buzzard actually has one of the 1012Ds there.
I was about to say, guys, if they do Australian railways, I'd like to see all the
American air.
Can we let him finish, Eddie, please?
For Christ's sake. I was trying to say, if we do the Australian railways, I know what I'd like to see. All the engines that went over to Australia during World War II. First and foremost.
What do you mean, World War One?
Well, World War One and World War Two.
I think somehow X-160s went over there too.
X-160s. Asia, they did not go to, yeah, they did not go there. They went to China and India and both the Koreas.
I'm wondering if North Korea still has it.
The last one was drawn in 1990.
I have just looked up about the Cape Donegal Railways Joint Committee, and the network that they inherited in total came up to 106 miles. That would be one hell of a route in DS, wouldn't it? A narrow gauge network spanning over 100 miles.
I'd be intrigued if somebody did Isle of Man, because technically you could do the whole island and just have all three routes in one.
What if the railway in India did not do?
Christ, that'd be a pain in the neck to do.
I think someone actually did do it for Freeware.
That's interesting.
I think narrow gauge is definitely the way to go. Like, if we're gonna do like more countries, like I think narrow gauge is perfect, because narrow gauge is widespread and it's even become somewhat interchangeable. Like I think would be interesting would be that that railway where the Welsh Highlands D2 has come from.
What, China?
Yeah, that Chinese railway.
That's like 680 mil. That's like...
really tiny.
That is a small set of trackage.
Oh, yeah.
That would be an interesting route, though, because that was still using steam traction until very recently.
Mm-hmm. And TS won't even launch for me now.
Something I'd like to see is the German industrial narrow gauge.
Now you've got me thinking about German narrow gauge.
Well, here's the thing, though.
Horace Mountain Railway for a start.
There's that. There's a couple of... There's hell to this day. And I actually talked to a person I know in Germany. They still have wireless steam locos running around. At the paper mills. There's like two paper mill branch lines that are like, 8 or 10 miles? That are like covered by wireless locos.
You know what you just reminded me of? Saying paper mill. I'm thinking the Sittingbourne and Hempstead railway. I'd be fascinated to do. Like a monarch that you can drive about, and that'd be interesting.
Yeah. Well, also, with same things like wireless locos, I know people are going to be jumping up and down and going, can you make this? Because it's something new, it's something interesting we don't have in PS.
I think a wireless engine would certainly be doable, like, just give it steam engine physics, but basically, like, you know, when you need to fill up, like when you need to top up the steam, it just brings like the boiler pressure up, and every time you move, obviously you lose a bit of pressure.
Yeah.
I'm just reading up on the Donegal railways, and I've got to say, it is fascinating. Like, oh my god, actually, just looking at this. 1909, the Joint Committee opened Drabain and Letterkenny Railway, and the County Donegal network in 1909 totaled 121 miles for a 3-foot gauge narrow railway. I think that's fantastic. By 1912, the company owned the following assets: 21 locomotives, 56 passenger vehicles, and 304 goods vehicles.
Yeah.
And of course, they started introducing diesel traction as well, which I think is interesting. I think, all in all, the County Donegal's joint committee would be really, really cool to have a TS.
Yeah.
And of course, the County Donegal network also went through Derry.
Derry.
I've got an interesting story about Derry, which is that my mate Dale and I went to a bar in Birmingham. I was out at the back having a cigarette, and Dale came out with me. He doesn't smoke, he just likes hanging out with me. And as I was standing there, I could detect an accent from behind me, and it sounded thick and Irish, and the way he was pronouncing the words, I thought, he's from Derry. I can tell he's from Derry. So I turned around, I'm like, excuse me, whereabouts are you from? And I was like, I'm from Ireland. And I'm like, whereabouts? Are you from Derry at all? And I'm like, yeah, that's right. How did you know? I'm like, because the Derry accent is very thick. And he went, oh, fair play to you. And I did the full impersonation. I went, I come from Derry in my car. And everything. That got him laughing as well. They said that was Bob on, he also said. And then Dale, pure, innocent, naive Dale, then went, well, are you from Londonderry? Are you from Londonderry? Are you from Londonderry? I was like, excuse me a moment, Dale, what the fuck? Because anyone who doesn't know in the audience, Londonderry is Protestant and Derry is Catholic.
Yeah, Londonderry is Northern Ireland.
They're both Northern Ireland.
No, I thought Derry was the Republic.
No, because it's basically the same. Londonderry and Derry are the same place. It just depends on. It's basically like depending on the spin of it. Londonderry is the Protestant swing on it, and Derry is the Catholic. So yeah, if someone says that they're from Derry, they're from Derry. Don't say that they're from Londonderry, because you're basically...
If you're genuinely curious, you could. They say that they're from Derry, you could ask which bit.
If they say they're from Derry, then you know which bit they're from. But yeah, I mean, you got to think, I mean, like the amount of political unrest there is over there. I mean, I've even been to Derry before. Though obviously I was calling it Londonderry when I was over there, and in fact, you can actually tell the Protestant areas very, very easily, because if you drive about in Londonderry, the Londonderry part of it, you'll note that the paving stones, like the curbstones, are painted red, white, and blue. Those are the Protestant areas. It's still, there's still strong feelings about it today.
And this is why I would never go to Ireland.
This is why I don't do religion.
You can't go to Ireland, you just have to be very, very careful.
I don't do religion either,
and
I really hate
games. I mean, kids involved, watch this. Gordon Brown tickles chickens.
Yeah, I know all of this because my dad had a few Irish girlfriends, and had one who actually lived in Londonderry. Though, again, technically Derry, because she was originally Catholic, but she married a Protestant.
So she's half and half.
Yeah, she was half and half, yeah. Caroline, her name was, and she was absolutely lovely, tremendous. Absolutely loved being around her. It was great fun. I love being around her. I've also been to... where else have I been? To an island with girlfriends. I've been to Bangor as well. Bangor in Wales. Not Wales, Ireland. But yeah, it was... Caroline's mother, she was a character. Because you know Nan has a take. Think of that, but Irish.
Ah.
That's what, she was exactly like that. Exactly like that. Like, one of the times I went over there, the snow had just dropped. And they were, you know, the gritter lorries were dropping off big massive piles of grit for all the people down the street to just help themselves to do their driveways.
Oh, dear God. I'm sorry to interrupt. FBS reportings 128.
Excellent. Anyway, yeah.
anyway.
Any good news? I finally got the wet and blue to work.
Okay. Anyway, so we were sat there in the lane, and we saw that this truck had come up and deposited a big pile of grit outside Caroline's mum's driveway. And she was looking out there. She let out a little smile, but she didn't say much. But then she started to notice. She noticed a woman from down the road coming up at. Oh God, that water tower is creepy. She noticed this woman coming up from up the road with a bucket and a trowel and basically helping herself with the grit. And she went, "You see, that's what I had to put up with all winter. She's been coming up here and stealing my grit. What a fucking liberty." Literally like that. She said, "What?
Without giving a shit."
Yeah, what a fuck. That's the crucial thing. What a fucking liberty. Just like Nan from Catherine Day. Yeah, I think that's one thing to say, which is that when you're dealing with people from Ireland, they've got a certain character about them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Speaking of which, Terry's up in the TS chat. Can someone move him down here, please?
No. Next!
No.
That's terrible.
No, I'm bringing him in.
Okay.
If that's okay with you, Steve.
Yeah.
Terry, you're now in stream.
We're good.
You're very quiet. I'm going to have to turn you up.
Okay. Yeah.
Ooh. A little bit. It's a little better, yeah.
He is having a Gordon on the turntable moment with his water tower.
Back. Oh. Forward. Oh. Upside down. Worth 62 degrees.
I just think the way that water tower top thing is. I'm just thinking hentai.
For God's sake.
And bastard.
Yeah, Adam Dreidel is being hentai'd.
Oh, Lord of mercy.
Bastard.
Ah,
dear. And I am currently drenching all the power lines on Woodhead.
Why, did you overfill the boiler?
Well, no, I'm basically climbing... I'm heading up the grades. I'm working hard with 7 coaches behind... a wee thing. And, on top of that, this is the 1970s Woodhead. So, 506s and stuff. Oh. All overhead electric locos. Which I knew there were people who hate them with a passion and want to see them fry.
Not really, because the 506 is apparently a model. Because Tom did a stream over the Woodhead in blue, because he bought it. Bit disappointed. He was a bit disappointed at the fact that the frames were rather poo. It's because it's covered in point light. That's the problem with it. But the modelling behind everything, like the Enhanced 76, he thought it was okay. Didn't think of it too much. But the 506 was fantastic. Fantastic add-on.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. And it's I can't believe that only the cab of a 506 remains. Mm-hmm. That is a shame. You got to think, it's perhaps one of the most unique electric units in the UK and doesn't survive.
Oh!
Did it go chuff, 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 chuff?
Well, not precisely, no.
We only move
up and down, that's for sure.
But
we get our members a chance to have a
go at
driving without starting or failing and
knowing that. So it just went
chuff
and
chuff. Well, someone made the wheel slip, that's for sure.
Oh, dear God.
Exactly.
Well, this is fully Pacific, so.
Yeah, well, gladly, Bossman Games have a file for development.
And I guarantee you'll be going to the Clan Line group for advice.
Yeah, exactly. They'll be possibly coming to us for advice, what bits to add, what sounds to add as well.
Mm-hmm. What they're like to drive, what they're like to fire.
Yeah,
exactly.
Out of interest, Steve, what is the actual destination code that you're putting on the back of the engine?
Lewis Green Sprinted.
That's the Bluebell head code.
Which is nice.
I really want to go to the Bluebell at some point. I want to go down to the Bluebell when they finish the Bryson Atlantic. Because I just think that engine will just be just totally gorgeous when it's done. Totally gorgeous.
I'd rather it be a Southern Olive, but oh well.
Rather than black.
You know what? I think those engines, if they can carry off BR Black well enough, then I've got no issue with that.
De Gaulle, do you mind? I can't see the screen.
Oh, I don't mind at all. Carry on.
Yeah, I saw them. Yeah, and Eddie. Oh, wait, he's gone, hasn't he? Stuff him.
You know what I'm thinking? Due to the mystery surrounding the zoo, I think what we need to do is we need to go over to Brazil and find it.
Well, we'd need to find the documentation of who it was sold to.
During the war.
Luckily, it wasn't damaged, the metal. They had to send some bits off to Rockley to get redone. And hopefully, it should be done as soon as possible in time for our next run, which is on the 20th. It's the Zoe's old performance. I uploaded some photos on Facebook of the headboard that Clanline wore over the years. My favourite has to be the Bournemouth Bell. That's my favourite.
Kind of a given, really.
Yeah. And now that Bossman Games rolls that competition for the Raw spot.
It'll be interesting to see who wins.
Well,
considering the fact I think Bretchington Smythe won the Black Fives, didn't he?
Yeah,
he did. Dick.
Lucky bastard.
Well, I'm not guaranteeing to win anyway.
Nobody is.
No, and I know for a fact I'm not going to win it. I never win anything.
Yeah, me both.
I didn't even win the egg and spoon me for fucking school, for Christ's sake.
Oh, I don't just throw the eggs at people. That's all I did.
I just find I think the whole story of Lou is very really nice. 28th December 1936, Lou sailed from Swansea on the SS Sabre, believed to have been destined for a plantation bill. Sabre arrived in Pernambuco. I don't.
If you put it in here, I might be able to pronounce it.
Pernambuco, I think.
Somewhere
in Brazil. And then it left that place of Brazil on the 17th of October and called it Bahia on 28th of October. And arrived at Rio de Janeiro on the 23rd of October. So, there's three places there where Lou could have gone off to. It could have been Bahia or Rio de Janeiro.
If it would have gone to Rio de Janeiro, it would have docked at Rio de Janeiro.
Oh, yeah.
Because Rio's got a port.
Mm-hmm.
No, but here's the thing. If Sabre arrives at the other two places, dropped off there. I'm wondering if Lou is like sat in a shed on one of these plantations, basically rotting away. That's what I'm wondering.
Okay,
Cal,
go
find
them.
What?
Yeah.
The interruption.
Well, I'm going to end the stream there, so thank you very much for watching, Eagles. Hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this, then please be sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe to see more content from the channel, and we will see you all in the next one. Ta-ra, Eagles.